girl needs to learn how to fix her bed.
Mommy, can I ask you something?
Sure.
Can I buy a can of Play-Doh? I have enough money for my birthday, and I pretty promise with a cherry on top, but I promise that I won't make a mess of it.
You're not buying any Play-Doh. It's a waste of money, and I'm sure of it, you're gonna make a mess.
But all my friends have it!
Well, go share with your friends. You're not buying any Play-Doh, young lady.
But they won't let me share!
Well, I don't care.
I think they're not letting me share with me because they don't know what the meaning of sharing and they didn't learn anything from going to preschool.
Well, that's your friend's loss. You're not buying any Play-Doh. Are you in a rut because your parents are saying you're not allowed to have Play-Doh because it's a waste of money and it's messy? Well, we're here to solve all your problems. Here are two easy and affordable ways to make Play-Doh. Now let's head on into the kitchen with Emily and Kyla.
Thanks, Rick.
Let's begin.
So we have 1 cup of flour in here. We used a measuring cup. It already has all the markings on here, and we measured it up to here, 1 cup.
And next we are going to use 1/4 cup of salt. And again, we're using the measuring cup.
And we're gonna measure it up to right here.
That's a lot of salt.
And then we're using 1 whole packet of Kool-Aid.
Next, we are going to use cream of tartar,
2 tablespoons. So we've got all the dry ingredients in.
And before you put some of the wet ingredients in, you should just try and stir a little bit.
But don't worry about the lumps.
Yeah, don't worry about the lumps and clumps. Just stir a little bit and then pour the water
in. So we've measured 1 cup of warm water.
Now you can mix it again a little bit.
Be very, very careful. Almost overflowed, but I didn't. 1, 2, next,
we are just going to
put it on the stove.
On medium. And we're gonna mix for 3 to 5 minutes. It's starting to get hard now and it's coming together. And you have to mix hard because, yeah.
And you have to be very safe because the rings are gonna get quite hot. And we have waited 4 minutes now and we're waiting just
for 4:29.
Yeah.
You gotta mix for like 45 minutes. I'm trying to.
And it's gonna get really, really hard, and it's gonna get really, really hard to stir.
Yeah. So it's coming together nicely. And now it's done.
You can turn so we off. Chose the flavor blue raspberry, and it just looks like this, and it comes in this packet. And you can also use like grape raisin, cherry, fruit blast.
And so now I'm just kneading it into a ball, and I'm trying to get all the lumps out.
Cause lumps are good.
Cause Play-Doh doesn't usually have big lumps in it.
And so it's gonna be
oily.
But the good thing is it does not, like, no color comes off on your hands. So that's good. And it smells really good.
So you don't want to touch it right away because it's still very hot.
And now we're just gonna take it and put it on the chopping board.
And then we're just gonna let it to cool, and then after.
So now the lumps are gone, and we are just going to wrap it in some saran wrap.
And it's also cool now.
Yeah. And you want to make sure there's no edges that are open.
Let's begin recipe number two. So we have 2 cups of flour here.
Now we're going to just get 1 tablespoon of cream of tartar. 1 tablespoon of that.
And then 1 cup of salt.
First we're going to get 2 tablespoons of oil. You want to make sure you do this over a sort of tissue paper because you don't want to get your whole surface wet.
We are making the color indigo, but of course you can make any color you want.
So we're gonna add 4 drops of blue and 1 drop of red.
So this is what the food color dyes look like. We are using just food color dye, not paste or anything like that, because this is just a lot simpler and a lot easier. 4 scoops of blue. 1, 2, 3, 4.
And then 1 drop of red.
And you want to mix it really, really well. So we're just going to add a little bit more color because ours isn't really, just looks a little white tinted blue.
3, 4, I guess.
And 1 drop of red
anywhere.
And now you're starting to get sort of a vibrantish color. This is really, really hard to mix. So if you need adult help, feel free to ask your mom or your dad.
Hey. So we have 6 colors and we cut them into 8 equal pieces. As you can see, we marked them with a knife.
We have 56 pieces, 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, 56. We're gonna give everyone 2 colors, so we need 46 pieces.
We have 23 people in our class and each will get 2 colors, so 23 times 2 equals 46 pieces.
We have 56 pieces and we will have 6 left over after we've given everyone 2 pieces each.
Hey, Natalie!
Hey, Kieran!
So, right now we're going to talk about our Play-Doh attempts.
What went right and what went wrong. I'm going to talk about the first one.
And I'm going to talk about the second one.
The first one went awesome and the other one went
wrong, bad, horrible.
Usually when you're doing a project or anything, the first one is horrible, and
the first one is usually, yeah, horrible.
The second one is great because you know what you need to do. But for us, our first one was actually better than our second one.
Amazing!
Because we knew what we needed to do. We had to put it on the heat, and we knew exactly what we were doing, so, yeah.
But, sadly for us, the second last attempt went horrible because us, being the people that we are, did not notice the next in big bold printing at the bottom of the page. So yeah, we were kind of disappointed. And we just thought you had to mix it up in the bowl and it would turn out into Play-Doh.
But it didn't.
We were just mixing and mixing for like hours and hours and it just turned out to be water. And we were like,
And plus, we put too much water in that one.
Yeah, we put too much. And it was just... And the differences between the two are... They're actually the same thing, except the differences are one uses Kool-Aid, one uses food coloring.
And the other difference is the Kool-Aid one smells way better because it's Kool-Aid.
And the other coloring one smells a little funky.
So what we learned is that you have to be really patient if things don't work out the way you think they will. Unlike some people who have zero patience.
She's talking about me.
Yeah, so you have to be really patient. And when you get frustrated, nothing works out. So you have to stay calm.
Like me, I got really, really frustrated because my iPod's battery kept on dying. So I was like... Why? And while we were recording,
the iPod fell.
And died, everything happened badly. Yeah. But you just have to remember that in life, you're always going to have your ups and downs. And this project was not an up, it wasn't a down, it was in the middle.
And stay tuned, because we have more fun coming.
Bloopers! And... when we come to class and you watch this video, you will all get little samples of each color Play-Doh